Hi all, welcome back to my class. This is my second video on photochemistry. In the first video, we learned Patanobuchi reaction and dimerization. If you have not seen it, you can get the link from the description box of this video. So basically, this video is for MSc, BSc, CSIR NET and GATE students. And if you are a BSc student, so you can see if the examples are there for acyclic ketones, cyclic ketones or bicyclic ketones, then you can watch the full video. So let's begin. Norrish type 1 reaction. So here we have to see what type of fission occurs here, fragmentation occurs here in the Norrish type 1. So first we have to keep in our mind, under Norrish type 1 reaction, alpha cleavage occurs, that is a homolytic fission of the ketone at alpha CC bond. Homolytic fission means here the free radical formation will occur with respect to the carbonyl group at alpha carbon bond. The reaction may occur in gas phase. If the reaction is mentioned in gas phase, that is above 100 degrees centigrade, then the decarbonylation will occur. Means the loss of carbonyl group will occur from the ketone. And for unsymmetrical ketones, with respect to the carbonyl group, so the free radical will form always where the more stable free radical is there. So like if the tertiary and primary free radical comparison is there, then the tertiary free radical will form over primary free radical, and that will give the more stable product. So before we start with the reaction for Norrish type 1, we will see a small energy level diagram. So what happens that for ketones, you have two types of electrons here. One is an electron, that is lone pair electron, and other is the pi electron because it has a pi double bond. Double bond is there. So two electrons are there, two types of electron. In the ground state, the electrons are paired. Okay, so this is the ground state energy level diagram. So if you have studied the energy level diagram in UV spectroscopy, where we know sigma, pi, and then pi star and sigma star energy level diagram. So the transitions are possible for carbonyl compound here. Either it can be N to pi star or it can be pi to pi star transition. Okay, so pi to pi star means one of the electron from the pi orbital will go to pi star antibonding, then it is called pi to pi star. And if one electron from the non-bonding electron go to the pi star, that is antibonding pi orbital, then it is called the N to pi star transition. So here in Norrish type 1, all the reaction will occur based on N to pi star transition. You can see the energy gap is less in N to pi star as compared to pi to pi. So this is a more feasible reaction since the energy gap is less. So N to pi star means one electron will excite to the pi star, and you can notice the spins are paired still. So this is called the singlet state, first excited singlet state. And since the energy difference here between the singlet and triplet, so here is less, you can see this energy level gap is less, the transition occurs from singlet to triplet, and the transition is called as intersystem crossing. So in the triplet state, what happens? The spins are parallel here, and the lifetime of the triplet state is more as compared to singlet. So basically all the chemical reaction occur from the triplet state as compared to singlet state. Being the lifetime more, the reaction will occur from the triplet state. Okay, and it is of course N to pi star transition. So we will see now first category acyclic ketones. So let's see the very simple example here, acetone. It is a carbonyl compound, and the photochemical condition will be given to you, H nu, light or photon will be given to you. If it is there and you have a carbonyl compound, so we can assume the reaction is from the photochemistry, and it may be the Norrish type 1 reaction. And if it comes in your mind, Norrish type 1, we know the alpha cleavage occurs here. So with respect to this carbonyl group, there are two alpha carbons here. Since both sides we have CH3, it is symmetrical, you can do alpha cleavage from either side. Okay, so let's say if we are doing from one side, you are getting the methyl free radical and other side COCH3 free radical. So two possibilities are there. The reaction may occur at room temperature. In that case, what happens? The two acetyl radical will recombine to give you this product here. Okay, or it may be the two CH3 will combine and will give you the product here. But in gas phase, what happens? In gas phase, this CH3CO also fragment, homolytic fission occur, and it will give you the CH3CO free radical, and the two CH3 free radical will combine to give you ethane, right? So at room temperature, this will, we know all the free radical species are highly active, right? So whatever possible combination you can do, you can form. Basically, the product will form, the major product will be based on the stability of the free radical. So gas phase, more fragmentations are possible and decarbonylation occurs basically. So we'll see this example. This is the case of unsymmetrical ketone. Now we know photochemically vapor means it is a gas phase, and once it is gas phase, we know in gas phase decarbonylation occurs always. Decarbonylation means the loss of carbonyl from here. So first of all, we need to see, so here you can notice, here the products are given here, acetone and this the dimer product, and hexane, methane and propene. Okay, so you need to form these products here. So in case of actually Norris type 1 reaction, that is alpha cleavage, basically the product will be given to you and you have to form that product by showing the mechanism. Okay, so we know the free radical stability with respect to the two, longer the chain, more stable the free radical. So this propyl free radical will be more stable if you fragment this alpha bond as compared to the methyl free radical. So we'll see what all possible free radicals are there. So first we will fragment this bond. So you'll get CH3CO free radical and other side propyl free radical. The other possibility, after this CH3CO, since it is vapor phase, decarbonylation, so CH3 free radical and then again CO free radical will be there. So since it is gas, so it will evaporate. So now the possible reactions in this reactive species, highly active species, therefore we have maintained a bracket, a square bracket here. So two CH3CO will combine to give you this second product here mentioned in the question, and the other possibility is this CH3CO will may combine with this CH3 and give you the acetone, the first product in the question. Two propyl free radical may combine to give you n-hexane, the next product, and we need to get now methane and propene. And how it is possible? You have a propyl free radical, you have a methyl free radical, then what happened? The disproportionation occurs here. The hydrogen from this carbon will give its electron to form a propene, and this hydrogen will go to the methyl and give you the methane. So basically in this way we are getting propene and methane as well. So if the product is given to you, it's very easy. You can just form the possible free radicals comes to your mind based on the structure of the product. Okay, and normally we form based on the stability, but for acyclic ketone you can do it. You have to just remember that if it is a gas phase, the decarbonylation will occur, okay, in the secondary process. So first process is this, the free radical alpha cleavage from the side where the radical formation is more stable, that is the primary process. And in the secondary process, if the vapor phase is there, then the decarbonylation will occur. These two steps you have to keep in your mind while solving the problem for Norris type 1, right? So first step is the fragmentation of alpha bond, alpha cleavage from the side where the free radical is stable, okay, more stable free radical will form. So we have done that. The second is, since it is mentioned vapor phase, then you can do the decarbonylation also. And now we have the active species, you can find all the possible combination and form the product. And if it is given, then you have to just see how you can form those products here. Okay, so in this reaction you can see we have the aromatic ring both side with respect to the carbonyl. So it is symmetrical one, photochemical condition is given. So alpha cleavage either side you can do. So one side we do, it is CH2, okay, free radical. It is benzylic free radical, so it is more stable because it is in the resonance. Therefore, the other side also the fragmentation will occur and decarbonylation will occur here. Okay, because the free radical is more stable as compared to PHCH2CO free radical. So, based on that, the decarbonylation will occur and it will form the two molecules of this PHCH2 free radical and the dimerization will occur. And you will get the 100% yield of this product, means there is no other possible combination here because you have the most stable free radical here. So the products basically form based on the stability of the intermediate. Now we'll see the example from cyclic ketones. So this is one example, and you can notice we have a 5-membered carbonyl ring here, and at alpha position both side we have pH, right? And just now we have solved this problem, so we know the answer that alpha cleavage, the free radical will form here, which is in conjugation with C6H5, so it is stable, and therefore the other side also, so decarbonylation will occur, and okay, this biradical is stable, and the decarbonylation will occur. This is the most stable diradical, okay, and what happens? It is going to form a 4-membered ring here, where the two phenyl will be opposite to each other because of its bulkiness. So trans product is going to form here after cyclization. Clear? So this is the next problem, cyclohexanone. Photochemical condition is given. If they don't mention gas phase, you are free to do photochemically whatever you want. You can do the decarbonylation also. And the product will be always based, the major product will be based on the stability of the intermediate. Okay, so since it is symmetrical, either side we can do it. So we have done from this alpha carbon, okay, free radical formation. And then first, one possibility is that intramolecular hydrogen transfer. So that this is like if this hydrogen next to the free radical, if it's transfer, okay, give its electron to the carbonyl, okay, so if it shift to the carbonyl, so you are getting the aldehyde here and it's give its electron to the neighboring this bond and you are getting a double bond here. So you are getting this double bond and carbonyl group here, aldehyde here. So normally for this reaction they will give you this reactant, and photochemically they will ask you to form this product. So if this product is given, you have to form it by the showing the mechanism. So and this we can get it only by doing the intramolecular hydrogen transfer. Okay, so from which carbon the hydrogen is migrating, if you consider this alpha, beta, gamma, delta, so this is the delta hydrogen which is migrating to the carbonyl group, leaving behind its electron to form a double bond. Okay, and the other possibility, we know that the decarbonylation, and you can do the diradical formation and form this product. But since the two free radical are here primary, okay, so this free radical, the intermediate state is not as stable, so the product is going to be less here, okay, least here, the minor here, so this is going to be minor. The major one is this, which is more stable one. Okay, so major yield is this one. In photochemical reaction, you have to think what all possibilities are there. So one is the diradical formation and then the ring closure. Another is the intramolecular hydrogen transfer to form the more stable product. So this is the unsymmetrical ketone photochemically. So first thing, we will see the alpha cleavage. Once you get this carbonyl type of compound under photochemical condition, two sides is there. Now we will fragment it from the side where the free radical will be more stable. And we know the stability of free radical will be more if it is more branched, okay, tertiary over secondary and over primary. Okay, so this is the primary free radical. If you fragment from alpha single prime side, if you fragment from alpha side, alpha carbon side, then it is going to be tertiary. So we are going to fragment it from this side, right? And Then what is the next possibility? One possibility we know, the decarbonylation, and it is going to form this product, okay, because you have one tertiary, another primary, so this is again possible. But we know that the intramolecular hydrogen transfer is also possible from the delta hydrogen, not only delta hydrogen, from delta carbon, other carbon can also show this property. So you will get this product also, as we got in the fourth reaction here. Okay, so as I told you, basically they will give you the reactant and they will give you the product. You have to design it by showing the mechanism. They may give you this one, they may give you this one, they may give both also, and we can have this possibility as well, where you can notice that the hydrogen transfer took place from this CH3 to the carbonyl, and you get the aldehyde, and you are getting here the C double bond CH2. So if you get this product, you have to show how it is possible. So then you can think of how formation of this product. The other possibility is the alpha carbon only, it is giving its hydrogen, okay. Hydrogen migration takes place to this carbon, where the substitution is there, and form the ketene. Okay, so this is another possibility. So if they give you the structure of product, then you can design it by showing the mechanism. Otherwise, if they don't give you, you can make the standard. Okay, you can make the standard product, like one is a diradical one. Another way, you can abstract it from the delta carbon and show the intramolecular hydrogen transfer. So this is another one where you have a 5-membered ring having a double bond O, okay, ketone, cyclopentanone, gas phase. So we know decarbonylation is possible here, though it is primary here, decarbonylation. So we know the primary are not as stable, so forming a 4-membered ring is least possible, because it is having the high strain also, right? The cyclobutane ring having strain, so this is not a major product here. So what will happen here? It will try to form the more stable product here by doing the abstraction of hydrogen from the alpha carbon, right? So with respect to this carbon, you can see this, we can say with respect to these two free radical, these two are the alpha carbons, right? And if you fragment it, it is going to form the alkene, and this is more stable rather than the cyclobutane. So this is first possibility. Another possibility is if the one of the alpha hydrogen, okay, is migrating to the other terminal carbon, leaving behind its electron, so it will give you the butene. Okay, this is another possible product here. The third possibility is if both the alpha dash hydrogen is leaving as a hydrogen gas, giving you the unsaturated butene. So this is the most stable, if you compare the three, will be the product here. Okay, so in this case also, they may give you the cyclopentanone, and they may give you any or one of this or two of this product. You have to design it by showing the mechanism, right? So otherwise, if you just leave your answer till here, so it is not correct completely, because it is the least product here because of the strain. So abstraction of hydrogen is possible always in case of Norrish type of reaction. This is again another example of cycloheptanone. Vapor means gaseous phase, and here you can notice that the products are mentioned here. So basically you have to design these products, and I hope now we have solved almost three problems, cyclic ketone. So you can just pause the video and try to solve this problem yourself. Anyway, I am going to solve it here, so you can just see the solution. So photochemically, we know alpha cleavage, symmetrical, any side you can do it, free radical formation. Then we know that this gamma, alpha, beta, gamma, delta, that is near to this free radical, the hydrogen abstraction takes place to form this double bond here and aldehyde. So this we got it, and in that way we are getting the first product here. So this we know how we can get it by the abstraction of hydrogen, right? And we know the decarbonylation process here from this structure. If you mention it A, decarbonylation means the biradical formation, and biradical, if it is going to recombine, it is going to give you cyclohexane. since it is primary free radical, it will not be a major product. Okay, so this is going to be less only. The other possibility is you can have here hexene. How it is possible? If the hydrogen is migrated to the terminal free radical and leaving behind a double bond here. Okay, so you are getting the hexene here. Compared to this cyclohexene, this is a stable one. So you can get this product here. Okay, among the all, the aldehyde one will be the major product here. The other possibility that you have to form propene, and how it is possible that if you fragment this center bond from here, it is going to give you the biradical, and by having this hydrogen migration to the terminal free radical, it is forming the two molecules of propene. Okay, so by following this mechanism, you can get all the mentioned product here. If they don't mention the product here, by default, you can form the two products here. The one is aldehyde one by showing the intramolecular hydrogen transfer, and other is the recombination of the biradical to form the cyclohexane. Okay, the other two, if they are mentioning, you can show this. Now the next category is bicyclic ketones. So this is our first example under this. Photochemically, vapor stage means it is the gaseous condition they have given you. And we know under gaseous condition, the decarbonylation occurs. And alpha cleavage, okay, Norrish type 1 possibility, we will assume here. And Norrish type 1. So it is going to form, the two sides are here, either it can fragment on this side or this side, it is symmetrical. So we are forming on one side, okay, and decarbonylation, leaving behind this diradical. Now we have the diradical. With this diradical, we know one possibility is the combination of these two will give you the strain product here. Okay, you can notice this is the 2,5 membered ring. One is this one and the other is this one. So both are like a strain. So this is not going to be the major one. What is the other possibility? If this sigma bond, okay, breaks, so it is going to generate one free radical here, which will combine and give you a one double bond here, and leaving behind another double bond here. And you are going to have this product which is more stable, and therefore it will be the major product here. Okay, so in this type of fragmentation, we always see whether the molecule, the product, does it have any strain or not. If it is having a strain, that product will be going to be minor, and the other one we have to find out how it will try to release it, that strain. So by opening this ring, it will release it strain, and therefore this is going to be the stable one and major one. So if you have this molecule, and this is again 5 membered ring having a double bond O, this is having strain. Photochemically gaseous phase, decarbonylation will occur and it is going to form a diradical. So till here it is clear. Diradical, one possibility you will do the this combination, which is going to generate a double bond, this cyclobutane ring here. The two cyclobutane ring are highly strained. So this is going to be very less here, minor product. The other possibility is how it is going to release its strain. So by opening this sigma bond, it is going to generate two electrons here, and that is going to form respectively double bond. So this is more stable one, and therefore it is going to be major. So this is how you can see how we are solving the problem based on the stability of the product. This you can do if they have given you the two products here and ask you to design it for this reactant. Okay, the conditions are mentioned here. So how to get these two products if they mention the structure of the product? So if you look at this structure and this structure, so you can assume, okay, alpha cleavage, diradical formation, and then how we can form it. If one of the hydrogen from this will be transferred to the carbonyl, leaving behind a double bond here and aldehyde. If you look at the other structure, then how it is possible? If this one of the hydrogen from this particular carbon will migrate to the terminal free radical, so a ketene is going to form, and in that way you can form this product as well. So basically the hydrogen transfer process, you are getting these two ones. This you have to show only if they have given you the structure of the product. Otherwise, you can just go by the basic rule that diradical formation and then the possible structure, one is going to be minor, other is going to be major based on the stability. So this is our last problem in today's lecture. Okay, so bicyclic category only, photochemically, and here they have given you the methanol, which is a protic solvent. Okay, and here the structure of the product is mentioned here and you have to get this product. So first of all, photochemically we know alpha cleavage, so we have done the alpha cleavage, two sides are there, we'll do from the side where the more stable free radical will form. And then what is happening, we have to get this product, and how we can get this product, you can just have a look, this oxygen of this carbonyl group is in the ring now. So what, how we can do that, if this double bond, okay, this pi bond is giving its one electron here and one is coming to the oxygen, and then this oxygen free radical is combining with this substituted free radical, leaving behind a carbene here. Okay, so the two free radical is here, carbene, and now methanol will, the oxygen on this methanol will give its electron to this, and you will get this final product, which is the product we wanted to get it. Okay, so in this way you can solve the problems from ketones, okay, category, acyclic ketone, bicyclic ketone and cyclic ketone under photochemical conditions. So basically, Norrish type 1 reaction, the first thing is the, you have to keep, do it alpha cleavage from the site where the free radical is more stable. If it is gaseous state, decarbonylation, diradical formation, and the product will be formed based on the stability of the product where you don't have any strain. I hope now this topic is clear completely, and you can solve any problems comes to you. So that's it for today. In the next video on the photochemistry, we will learn the Norrish type 2 problems. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment box. Till then, bye bye.